Hey guys, welcome to the chat. So this is the first time we do a Binance live stream. Hello, I'm Jessie from Seascape. Hello, so today we are happy to tell you guys a new game that we are happy to share with you all. It's called Moonscape. So without further ado, let me show you guys some good trailer. How about that? Hello, Binance user 30C17, and hello, eCash XEC. Hello. Yeah. Welcome, Kane and Kent. Hi, Binance JMOH. Hello. All right, without further ado, let me turn down this music a little bit and let's jump right into it, shall we? Alrighty, let me just make sure that the volume isn't too crazy. All right, let's go.
We once tried to harness the power of the moon. What fools we were. A new world was created. Nothing like our own. Here we struggle to survive. Our farming ain't much, but it's honest work. Those who prosper create settlements. Within the cities, coin is king. Many will flock to share in the wealth. Those who are stronger take from the weak. Will you band together to protect what is yours? Seascape presents the very first lighthouse project, Moonscape. Will you join us on the moon?
All right. Thoughts, comment, opinion? I personally feel like this is really good. I personally love it so much. Like, I love that narrator. I love everything about it. So yeah, what do you guys think? So let us now, hello, we got more people coming into the chat. Hi guys, welcome to the Moonscape live stream on Binance. Hello. Hi, so cute. Thank you, 94123. Thank you. All right. Let me introduce my guest today. He is the designer of Moonscape. Let us welcome Erlen. Hello, Erlen.
Hello, everyone.
Yes.
Hey, everyone. Hello.
You want to have a little bit of the introduction of yourself? How about you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, I am Erlan. I am the lead designer of Moonscape. I am from Latin America, and I am very enthusiastic about video games. I have thousands of games, not playing all of them, of course. And yeah, I am hyped to be here and to talk about Moonscape and to introduce the game to our audience.
Nice. So you have a lot of game, is it? You're a hardcore gamer? Nice. I like your t-shirt. Do you want to share a little bit
exactly,
more about
I
it?
I do have many games. Too many games.
Yeah, that's great. I said I like your t-shirt. Do you want to share how your t-shirt looks like? Nice. Mine is almost the same, but just a little different. Nice. Hi, Vavan B-Talk. Hello. Welcome to the chat. Nice. We have so many people watching us now. Are you nervous, Erlen? Well, so little things about Erlen is that he lives on the moon. Yeah, so he lives on the moon. His internet connection isn't the best. All good. All righty. Let's jump right into playing the game, shall we? All right. Let me share my screen. So first thing you need to realize, you need to really know of, is that you have to connect your wallet first, which before you're joining the game, you need to connect to your wallet first, okay? All right, hello, Crypto News. He's not, lol. Hi, hello, Binance users. Welcome to the chat. Next time, I can highly suggest you guys to create your own username so I can give you a shout out. Okay, so first things first, you will need to connect your wallet through this game. And even though we just finished our closed beta for the game, but we are going to have another release very soon. So stay tuned to our socials. You can see the socials down below to follow us for the latest news. And let's jump right into it. So I think Erlang returned to his moon. So don't worry about it. Let me see. All right. So I remember how to play this game from the previous Twitch stream that we had. So how do you go around with the rover? You can either do like a traditional gamer style to do WASD, that you can do WASD like this, or you can also use the arrow key, whichever the one that you feel the most comfortable for you. And here you have your map that you can see. The blue one, the dark blue one, is your home base. Is it free play to earn? Yes, when it is out, it is free play to earn. You can have fun with it. All right. So I can enter my city. So this is my city. So in the early access, you will need to have a different city NFTs to enter this game. But right now, when the game is fully fully released, you don't need to have a city NFT to get in. All right. Okay, I think we have Erlen back. Hello, Erlen. Hi.
Yes, the connection from the moon is never good.
Yeah, the connection in the moon is never good. We get it. So I was just telling people how, like, in the early access, you will need to have a city NFT. So there's someone who asked, is it a free play to earn game?
Yes. So only in the early access or closed beta or similar kind of releases, that is only for a limited number of players. But in the full release, it's totally free. You just go and log in and play the game. No need to do anything related to blockchain.
Yes, that is from the expert. He is the father of Moonscape. Yes. All right, I hope that answered your questions. Crypto News 7. All right, let's keep on going. So I'm about to enter my city. So let's see. I haven't seen my city in a while. I miss my baby. Let me see. Yes. So yes, this is my city. So you can have different You can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can have 5 cities in your, you can have 5 buildings in your cities, and you can have 3 cities in total. I only have 1 city right now, but in each city, inside each city, you can have 5 buildings. So let's see. So this one, you can upgrade your rover. This one, you can do your resources and mining research. And this one is also for rover. And this one is the city defense. So right now I'm at level 3. So level 3 right now. So I need to, if I wanted to, for example, make my doom a level 4, I will need to first have my city to be at least level 4 to get in. Sounds fair to you guys? Yeah, Ellen is back to the moon. Yeah, no worries. So let me just give you a little bit of a little bit of taste of how my city looks like. But you can customize your city as however you want it. You want it to have 2 access to your rovers. You can do it. You can have 3 asset mills. You can have 4 transaction squares. However, the way you want it, you can do it in your own style. And when you upgrade to your city, when you upgrade your buildings will be taller and fancier. All right. Erlen, are you ready to join back?
I don't know. Can you hear me well?
I can hear you very well. So do you still remember those names of the city, the buildings?
Transaction. Depends. Transaction.
This is a quiz for Erlen. Yeah, so what is this one called?
Wait, I cannot see your screen right now. This is asset mill.
Asset mill. Good job. What about this one in the back here?
Wait, I think that is the forge. I think. For something for
I give you the stage and you blew it. What about this
one? I am checking your screen another thing because this should be Industry Inc. As far as I remember.
Industry Inc. All right. What about this one?
Something with power plant.
Yes. And what about this one, the last one?
Okay, that's easy. Transaction Square, because the other and the only other.
Yes, Transaction Square. Good job. You passed my test from the almighty Jesse. Okay. Okay, now it's my test. So, for disclaimer here, guys, I might look like a pro gamer, but I'm so bad. I'm so bad at video games. My hand, when I freak out, I just cannot control my finger. So when we're fighting aliens or when we're attacking other cities, I'm just, you'll see. You'll be like, oh yeah, she can't play. All right, let's go. So I personally like the traditional gamer style because I'm a right-handed, so like my mouse is on my right hand, so it's better for me to use my left hand to do a WASD. So I'm doing that. But feel free to do however you want it. So last time, I've already put some of my resources that I would love to go and see how my babies are doing.
You can check on the map. Where do your resources are, right?
Yeah, see? Look how it's sucking all of the resources. Nice.
All the kryptonium.
Wow, look how much. Can I collect it?
Sure.
Yeah. Resources. Yes, yes, yes. Wait, if I have too much resources, do people will just come and attack me?
Yes. Definitely. Oh, no. But it doesn't work that way. The enemy cities are assigned at random, so they cannot decide to attack you.
Okay, good, good. All right, here's my another baby that he's been working hard. Ooh, I collected so much. Yes. Nice.
Let's hope you don't get attacked by an alien on the way.
I hope so. There's my another baby. Oh, I think it's the same thing. Yes, I already collected it.
No, but it's separated. Yes, it's separated per resource point.
So rich. I feel like, you know. Yeah. Oh, this one. Nice. My yield stone. Nice. My hardworking babies. All right, and the other one is coming there, the yellow one.
To the right, yes.
Nice. Yes, decentralized. Nice. My goodness, I got so much resources. Yes.
Now you can upgrade things, yes.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Get ready.
Uh-oh. I just... Okay. All right.
So you want to explain how to play before you click OK?
Yes. So when you attack an alien, it will show you first an arrow that you need to, like, you'll be like up, left, right, down, and you need to fix it in a very short amount of time. And then it becomes like a symbol that you need to match. Yeah, you need to match that symbol to the shield, to the right spot to get that attack. And I never hit it. I never hit that spot. It's my ultimate goal today. No one can leave until I hit that spot. No, I hijack everyone. Okay? All right, I'm so not ready. All right.
But to be specific, the arrow is to attack and the other is to defend. So you are trying to reduce the damage.
The arrow is to attack and the shield is to defense, to protect yourself. Okay.
Yes.
Do you have faith in me, Erlen?
You can do it.
All right. Oh my god.
Good.
Oh my god, that is so far away. Down, up, left. Okay, I can do it. Down, left, up, down. Okay,
you need to beat that.
Oh my god, almost got.
Okay, not bad.
Up, left, up.
No, it was fine.
Yes! Okay. Is that a big one or a small one? I can't tell anymore.
The weakest one.
I thought that's at least a medium. I genuinely thought at least that's a medium one. Yep. Okay. All right. Okay.
But you did it.
I did it. Okay. So can you explain what this is?
So this is an enemy city.
So every this is an enemy city.
Every map will have the map of each player. We have a number of enemy cities. That means other players. You can go into their cities, attack the cities, and if you manage to destroy at least one of their buildings, you steal their resources. So like from the resource pool that you can see on the top, you take that.
Okay, so how do I steal their resources?
Yeah, so when you if you get close to the city, you will see a symbol like yes, an icon on the top. Yeah, you click on the icon. And then, yes, you enter. If you click on any of the buildings, you can click on the building and any.
Okay, I click this one.
And it will say how much are you going to steal. This is a percentage of the total of the of that layer. And then when you are ready, you just click on attack. And the attack gameplay will start.
And how will the attack look like?
Yeah, so you need to move your rover in real time, like you move your rover around, and you need to avoid the turrets that are going to shoot at you. And also you need to use the space bar. You need to press it and hold it, don't lift it. And a triangle will move on the screen, and you need to match the both triangles, like on the screen one and your. This is to attack. But there is also the city is protected by a shield, like a dome. So you need to match it, so you do it between the shields. You do it and you will know. You can do it. I believe in you.
Okay, whatever you say. All right. I think I can do it. Let's just...
You have 2 minutes to do it. It's plenty time. Just try not to die.
Okay. Let me do it. All right. 3, 2, 1. Let's attack. Okay. Oh my god.
Okay, now you need to press the space bar to yes. You are okay, right now as you can see, there is no triangle means you are too far from the building. You need to be closer. Right now the building selected is the top one. Closer.
Oh my goodness.
Go top. Go to the top.
Oh where are
Yes.
Now you can try me. To what? Oh my goodness.
So you need to release it at the moment. Yes, like that.
I know. I know.
You're about to die.
I mean, well,
you survived 40 seconds.
At least I tried.
Yes.
I personally think I did a pretty good job. Thank you.
You can go inside of the city so I can explain something to the viewers, and also you can upgrade your
my city, right?
Yes.
Okay, now I have resource. Let's go back to my city. It's on Moonbeam. Yes, -10 TYA. It is on Moonbeam. Yes. Okay.
Okay, so click on the first one, the blue one, the dark one.
Yes.
And this is for our users. So every building have a DeFi section. So the core feature is to do something related to gameplay, but the DeFi is to do something related to DeFi, of course. Because the early access is already finished, Jesse is playing like a testing version, so that's why it doesn't have the pools. But you have a variety of pools that you can stake single tokens, you can stake LP tokens, you can stake NFTs, and you get rewards as usual from a pool. And
yes.
Also, the gameplay affects the rewards. So the higher your building, the level of your building, the higher the rewards you will get. With a bonus,
yes.
you get earnings and also a bonus depending on how high is your building. That was not available on early access. It will be available in a future version.
Yeah, because I'm doing the beta one because we're not releasing the official one yet. So that's why you can't see the pool right here. But all the other functions we can still show you guys.
Yes.
So explain to us, Ellen, how does this work?
Yes, so the attack is simply to do more damage. So when you increase attack, you do more damage, both to the aliens and to the city, so to the building. So yeah, so you just click yes.
So I can click yes?
Yes, sure. And also you have the rate. The rate is every time you attack on the city, you need to have a cooldown. With the rate, the cooldown is faster.
So I see. So the cooldown will be faster if we upgrade to the rate.
Yes.
So don't forget, guys, that it has a certain time limit for you to upgrade your rovers or upgrade your buildings and cities. So I remember how about you can explain a little bit of moon dust to us.
Yeah, so moon dust is, as you cannot see it right now, but moon dust will be the premium currency. The game has a token called MSCP, and you can use that token to get moon dust, and with the moon dust you can do a lot of advantages in the game. So you can, for example, right now the boost, if Jesse click on the boost part, you can use resources, but in the main game, you will need to use moon dust to increase the time. So to have an advantage in the game. And other uses that will be like explained later with further versions. So now
yes.
You can click, you have a lot of resources right now, you can just boost instead of wait 8 hours.
Yeah,
eight
I'm
minutes.
Rich. Haha. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Nice. Now I'm level
now,
2.
Yeah, go to level 3.
All right. I can boost.
And boost it, yes.
I love it when I can boost it.
Now, as you can see, you can boost that, no worries. Now, as you can see, the attack you cannot upgrade anymore. And that is because
yes,
your building is level 3.
Yeah. So my building is level 3. That's why I cannot go even further than level 3.
Yeah, so you need to now upgrade your building in order to upgrade the...
So I can upgrade my city.
Yeah,
oh, wow. It's expensive. All right. I see.
And
if
as you can see, it will take a really long time to upgrade.
Yeah, so I can boost it.
You can boost
to make it fast.
Yes.
Nice. So now I can upgrade it again.
Yes.
Nice.
Well, maybe you want to go to another building so you don't spend all your resources on this.
Yes. How about here? So can you explain what this is?
Yes, so this is to improve the mining. So with that, you improve how well your machines do the mining, how much resource they get per hour. And also the machines in the early access, we didn't have that, but in the future version, the machines need to be repaired. You cannot just leave it and forget about it and never come back. You need to repair it or they will stop getting resource. So you with all this you increase that. Longer repair time, longer time before you need to repair, and more extraction, etc. So you can start upgrading.
Okay. So is it only for the yield stone or other things as well? Only for the
yield stone. You need to everything you need to create several buildings in order to get all the functions.
Resources. Okay. Cool. Let's see. This easy peasy. Yes, we can do it. Let me upgrade it. And then I can boost it. See? So it's the structure now is 330. The construction time is 60 seconds. And the extraction is 75 per hour. So that increases. I see.
The construction time is... Again, in early access is fast. In the main version will be longer. That's why it needs to be improved.
Okay. All right. So it's only because it's the early access. That's why the construction time doesn't change. But when we actually release this game, the construction time will change into like a shorter time, the more you upgrade it. Nice. Should I go for another one? I think we have plenty of resources. We can totally.
You have plenty.
Yeah. Boosted. Nice. So now because we only are level 3 in this building, that's why we cannot go any further than that. So I will personally upgrade this building into a level 4 building.
And that will be a lot of resources.
I know, but yes, I think I wanted to do it like just now. So is it getting larger? Like when will the building change the form?
It changes on level 3, 5, 8, and 10, as far as I remember.
Okay.
So maybe if you increase 1 to level 5, it should change the form.
Sure. When I go to level 5, then you'll change into a different one. I see.
Yeah, a different one.
All right. What about this? Kryptonium.
So this building is to have more machines. So the previous building is to make the machines work better, but this is to have several. That's why outside on the map you have 2 Kryptonium machines, but all the others you have only 1 because of this building.
Yes.
In this building you don't upgrade the function. You upgrade the building and automatically it will unlock the other functions.
Sure. So there's one user in Binance are asking, how do we earn in the game through playing? That's a really good question. Erlen, do you want to explain it?
Mm-hmm. So besides the DeFi pools that we just talked about it, also all the cities, you can turn it into NFTs. So you can just play the game, create cities, nice cities with high level functions. You mint that city, so the city you will lose it in the game, but you will turn it into an NFT, and then you can profit from that NFT. Also, the rovers, you can do the same. You can level up the rover, and then you mint it, the rover will become an NFT, and you can sell it for profit. And in this game, in the early access, only 1 NFT, but we have multiple. As a later version, we have 8 NFTs are planned for a later version, probably next one.
Exactly. So that's really nice. So I can customize my own city, right? I can upgrade it to however the way I want it and make it very unique. Yep. And then you can transform it into an NFT that's very unique, and then you can trade it outside on our Scape store. Nice. Okay, so I hope that answered your questions. No worries, thank you so much. All right. So let's go. I wanted to upgrade this one, because we already have 2 mining machines. So I just wanted to boost this. Okay, come back. What about this one? I think this one is also for rover, is it?
This one is rover, yes, it should be.
So what does this mean?
Okay, yes, so this is, so when you first create a building, the building is empty of the function. So it will tell you, okay, you can upgrade the rover there, but it doesn't tell you. You need to choose what kind of skill you want. So if you click on there, yes, so you can see, you can upgrade the weapons that you use on city attack, or you can upgrade the speed and rate of fire. No, there must be a mistake there. So you can upgrade the speed and the defense, so you can hold more damage. And the next one, it should be range or something else. Yes. So this is to improve the chances to get the...
Does it have any levels in those improve?
Yes, the same as the attack and rate of fire that we improved in the others.
So let
us... You can try with weapons.
Yes, let us do weapon first. Ooh, and then I can upgrade?
Yes, so this upgrade works differently. This upgrade works differently. Instead of the weapons get better, you get more chances to use it. If it's only level 1, you can only use it once per attack. But level 2, you can use twice and so on. And the weapons are the most expensive. So I think if you try to upgrade, they are double than the other functions.
Because they're double.
Most useful.
What about this one? think I can do it too.
This one is very good because you don't need to aim. You just press on the space bar and automatically shoot.
Yeah, that's perfect for me. All right. Okay, then I'll come back. Should I upgrade? Oh, I already upgraded. So you're saying that on level 5, I could the building will change a little bit, right? Mm-hmm. I kind of wanted to see the one in the middle. I wanted to see how it looks like.
I think that one is the one with the most obvious
beach. Oh, yeah?
All the ones you have right now.
Oh, my goodness. It's so expensive.
Basically, you're spending all your money on this.
Yeah, I spent all of my money to be pretty. Yes. Ooh, look at these.
Yes.
Wow, so pretty. I love it. So yeah, when you go to level 5, you'll have a different style of building, which is very exciting for me. So, okay. Do you want me to exit?
Or you can enter the other green building, the one that have a weird shape that I totally forgot the name. The refinery is that building.
What's that? The green building.
Because this will help to defend the city.
This one. Oh no.
The other one.
Yeah. I totally forgot about this one. All right, so I can upgrade the dome, so it'll help me do better.
No,
I kind of want. Don't want to boost it.
Sure. This city defense is the opposite. Instead of helping you attack, it helps you to make life more difficult for an attacker. So when someone attacks your city, your defenses are going to be better.
Yeah, so if the more I level up in the city defense, the harder it is for your enemy to attack your city. I'm gonna leave them right here because I feel like I spent way too much money on boosting them. So I think city defense can wait a little bit.
It is expensive.
All right. Cool. So what is
maybe
mine?
Maybe you can boost only that one. So we can show it.
So I exit?
No, you enter the building again and boost only the one that say hidden mine.
Ah, okay. All right. Okay. That's nice. All right. So if I collect my resources, for example, let me go to one of my resource spot. If I collected the resource that from the spot, it just stopped doing the work, is it?
If you remove the machine, yes, and you need to move it to another place.
So here. I thought that one was mine, so I was like, hey, where's my machine? So your machine will still be there. So let me see. So it's still like mining.
Yes.
Kryptonian and all of that.
But yeah. You can instead of click collect, you can click unpack. You can do it.
Okay. I don't need, what is unpack?
You will see.
Oh, okay.
It removes the machine. So now you have another spot. And then you can put it there. Yeah, this is because, as you can see, the resources are limited. So it's not like it will have an amount. So you can need to move around there.
Ah, okay. I can do it here. There's another one here. So I can start construction. Nice. And then you'll keep on collecting stuff for me. Well, I think we can stop like here.
Sure.
And all right, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you think I do?
A good 8.
A no, good A. Okay. No, fair. Fair. I'll take that. All right.
Yeah, it was not bad.
Thank you so much for coming and joining us. Say bye to Ellen, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. I hope you have a good day. Thank you for guiding me in the moon. I'll see you again in the moon someday, okay?
Sure. With bad internet connection, but welcome.
But it's the moon, so it's fine.
It's a privilege, yes.
Do we want
for sure. Bye, everyone.
Well, thank you. Bye-bye. All right, guys. Let's see. I think it's a really nice way to show you guys how this game works. And so thank you guys so much for joining us. And if you have any questions, if you have anything that you wanted to say to us or interact with us, we do this stream every the same time every Wednesday and Friday. So I hope you guys have a good day, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. And make sure you follow these links so you can see the latest news. All right? Thank you so much. So I'll see you guys next time. All right? Bye. Take care.